one would attempt to climb up the mountain of enlightenment, self-awareness, or to be self-realized and then fully realized, ultimately being self-actualized, you'll say, there is a degree of understanding that should accompany any inquiring mind. First of all, patience. For if any would understand that this life is but one breath in the life of the soul, and that the soul itself lives forever, then there is no need to rush. What is the hurry? Enjoy the breath fully and to the optimal amount that one can enjoy a breath. Then, with this basic understanding, realize that the approach to God, the approach to the Godhead, the approach to the Christos, or that consciousness that would be favored by Amelius, by other avatars who have come into the world and have achieved full realization of themselves, then the pathway that the self takes in this experience may be different than the path in another experience. However, as one would indeed attempt to climb that mountain, they would take their own path. It may not be similar than another taking a different path, or it may be indeed in harmony with many who are taking a broad path at that point towards the peak or the top. It does not matter, save that there is only the realization that there is only one peak, but there are many pathways up that mountain to acquire the peak. That said, psychic development, or the evidence of the spiritual aspects of the soul, to be aware of all things, so to speak, is obtainable. But one has to want to do this in the first place. Then there has to be a purpose or a reason for doing so. Those that would attempt to understand healing and disease in the body, their willingness, their understanding of the physical body, their clairvoyance, telekinetic ability, and feeling or clairsensibility would add to their vocation. These tools of the soul are always at the disposal of any in their regard or vocation. A businessman wanting to know the future, or a farmer wanting to know future weather conditions, being able to cast their mind forward, would find this as a productive and prosperous ability that would add to their vocation. Again, no improper use here. However, using this with enlightenment and the understanding of the spiritual worlds, this would be the proper and more advantageous use of the soul mind itself. For greed, lust, power, dominance, position or privilege stand in the way of those who attempt to seek their innate spiritual abilities in some way or fashion, or greed, vanity, self-deception, or deceit may follow, and they may indeed grow a swelled head and not understand that as you migrate up that mountain, the path becomes steeper and steeper as you approach the top. Therefore, one must make careful that they know and believe as truth, that they continue to follow it, for if not, they will slip, and nearing the top, the slip will cause them to fall greatly, almost back to the beginning again, in which they will then endure the trials and tribulations of ascending that mountain again. In order to develop the spiritual or psychic abilities that are within, begin with the interpretation of dreams, or entering into the deeper states of meditation. Learn to relax the mind and disassociate the physical world from the mental world. One must be accepting of these rules and practices. First and foremost, no intrusion into the welfare of another. It is acceptable to intervene from time to time, but it is not acceptable to intrude, nor should any steal the free will and free choice of any other. Each must move forward on their own responsibility. However, it is through the states of meditation, quelling the mind itself, affecting the monkey mind to be tame, and so that the elephant mind may come forth, that of the asp the serpent, the snake-like influences, the kundalini developing through the chakra points or gates, may come into the mind and affect the glands in the mind. It would make the self all-knowing or all-aware, you'll say. But again, patience, for there are those influences, those entities and dimensions that would cause mischief, difficulty, or disharmony to exist. Or if one moves quickly, there can be mental abrasions and contusions, shall we call it, and as such, one may come in contact with influences that would attempt to influence the self to do their bidding or will, rather than those that would be amplifying, that the self might broaden and deepen the mental, intuitive, or spiritual abilities. By going slow, seeking out the teachers, and assessing always the path upward, bringing to the self what is truth, rejecting old inadequacies or old concepts that no longer are truthful. This allows the migration, the progression, in a healthy way, to the greater understanding or consciousness. But knowing all things, knowing how everything works, knowing the secrets of nature, is not the pathway to God. Knowing whom the self is, knowing the strengths and weaknesses of self, being able to put the self in a closet, and there in understanding you will find your greatest friend and your greatest enemy, and having the willingness to face the enemy, to overcome those inadequacies within the self. This does take great strength, great dedication, great humility, and of course it develops great awareness and closeness to the Godhead itself. Work silently and understand those that get the credit usually do not get the reward. Those that move forward quietly, humbly, assisting wherever they can, automatically develop the intuitive abilities within. The bottom line, in order to be a better intuitive individual, become a better person. Learn humility and forgiveness, tolerance and understanding. And then you can see within the self those same inadequacies, and you can apply the same to the self. But along the way, practice daily meditation. Enter the holies of holies and discover what strengths would be within the self.